make some noise. Yeah, independent, doing what you're told.
It's LOTv, National Arts Festival, you know, and right now we're with the only female stand-up comedian. Right, and this is Angel. And,
hello.
You know, we just actually came from watching your show.
Yes.
Very funny.
Thank you very much.
Very funny. First thing I need to ask, I think it's an obvious question, but I have to ask it.
Mm-hmm.
Are the ladies funnier than the men?
How? Well, that's an on the spot question. I'd say everyone's funny as they are. Like, that's, you know, like, are men funnier than other men?
Yeah.
I could say, like, girl power, yes, of course we are. But no, like, most of my favorite comedians are men.
Yeah.
They just need to be more women so that it can balance it out to them. The reason that there's less funny women is just because there's less women in comedy.
Yeah.
And if they, like, for every 10 people you see, one is a woman.
Yeah.
So of those 10, the odds of that one being your favorite. but so right now there are more men, but women and men are equal, funny. Come on, feminist equality.
Okay, now that's cool. And then in terms of the shows in Grahamstown, do you feel like the Grahamstown, are they getting it? Because sometimes you tell a joke and you can just talk, it's crickets.
Yeah.
Like, people don't understand. But is Grahamstown, are they getting it?
Well, I mean, every audience is completely different always as a comedian. And some jokes land, and then the next day that exact joke just won't land. But in general, the Grahamstown audiences are great because they're here for theatre, they're sitting, they're paying attention, and they're listening. So, for the most part, it's amazing. But yeah, some of the jokes that were like hilarious tonight. Last night they were like, yeah, it's okay. So, you know, and that's what's great with comedy. Every time, you're never really sure. You just throw out a thought, and if they catch it, otherwise, no.
That's good. Okay, and then the biggest audience you've ever performed in front of, how big?
The biggest audience was the Kings and Queens of Comedy for Comedy Central, and that was about 4,500.
Wow.
Yeah, that was big. I almost cried backstage. Before. You know when you're holding it together, like you hurt your knee and then your mommy says, "Ah," and then you're like, "Mommy, don't." As soon as someone gives you sympathy, then you cry. That I was backstage and then Jason Goliath came and I was about to go out and he gave me a big hug. And as he hugged me, I was like, "I'm gonna cry, I'm so scared." And I was like, "Don't hug me." But when okay, I didn't fall and I didn't forget my lines. So,
right. And then the last two questions is about the actual creative process.
Mm-hmm.
Like, how do you come up with this stuff? Is there like an independent committee where you're testing this stuff out, you know, in the auditing, and they're like, okay, that's funny.
Yeah.
Scratch that one, you know, that's up.
Well, you do, when you say that, yes, because all of our friends are comedians, like all of my homies are the other comics. So I'll be like, oh, I'm thinking about doing a joke about this. And they'll be like, that's funny. Do you know what you could also say? Da 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 da. And I will do the same for them. So there is that writing process. But generally, the first concept will just hit you in the most random times. Usually for me, when I'm driving, because then your brain's just clear. And then suddenly you're like, oh, I have. But then also, you know, you have a conversation. And then you're like, actually, I'm annoyed by that. And then you think, oh, that's quite funny. Like, if I say something I make you laugh, I'm going to remember it and maybe turn it into a joke later.
That's cool. And then in terms of after, you know, festival, because I'm sure life of a comedian, what's going on after?
Well, we've got the Comics Choice Awards coming up in August, which is always our highlight. And all of my good friends have been nominated again, so it's very exciting. I wasn't nominated again, which I'm not upset about.
Give it some time. It's going to happen.
Anyway, so we've got that coming up, and I mean, we just go back into the grind. I've got corporate gigs coming up, and go back to the club circuit and play Parkers and Cape Town Comedy Club and all of that stuff, all over Cape Town, Joburg. We kind of jump.
Okay, cool. Last question. This is a serious question. What do you think it's gonna take to get the rest of the country to sort of where Cape Town is? Because the two sort of big comedy scenes is Cape Town and Joburg.
Yes.
So what's it gonna do? Because not everywhere is there a bachelor theatre.
Yeah.
Type of thing.
Exactly.
You know, what is it gonna take for us to get for the rest of it, for everyone else?
That's like a bigger question. Like, what's it gonna take for the rest of the country to catch up with Cape Town and Joburg with everything?
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. I mean, it's great, there's a lot of comedy that tours to the smaller sort of towns and goes to the town halls and things, and that's always like they're so great and they're so excited because they've never, you know, seen stand-up in real before. Because what you see on TV and stuff is so like edited and proper family friendly. And so when you come to the underground and these kinds of like a freedom of expression art festivals, you really see the gritty. So I don't know what it's going to take. I think just more people to invite comics to come and play at their town hall. So if you're watching this and you want comedians, just contact us and say, like, we want to, you know, put five of us on the lineup, you know, pay us a little bit. We're very cheap. We have no morals. So yeah, I think and people must just go out and be hungry for live comedy, because then the industry, supply and demand, it will happen. Look for it.
Okay, cool. Speaking of bookings and all that, how can people get you either social media? Where can they watch your clips? How can they book you?
Well, the best hub is my website, www.yesreallyangel.com. Pretty easy. Cameraman's laughing. My Twitter is @yesreallyangel and Facebook/yesreallyangel. It's pretty complicated, I know. They're all over the place. Instagram's also yesreallyangel. I was lucky. No one on the internet had thought of that.
Absolute last thing. What's the funniest thing you've ever heard?
Oh, so many funny things.
Where you actually had to say, oh, okay, that was funny. Because I'm sure by now it takes a lot.
Oh, well, probably that the fire pool was a security upgrade. Pretty hilarious stuff. Mr. President, stop taking our jobs.
So yes, that was it. LOTV, you were with the angel. And it's Yes, Really Angel.
Yes.
That's like across
really
the board.
Yeah.
We hope, you know, she enjoys the rest of her time in Grahamstown.
I hope
you
so
know,
too.
We hope to see you back again.
Yes.
Next year.
I'll bring a new show next year.
So yes, that was it. LOTV, National Arts Festival.
Hello.
It's tough though, don't laugh sir. It's tough being a woman, okay? Because we're always competing with each other, like we're always judging and these hoes ain't loyal, you know, like...
Hello people, I'm Angel Campy, also known as Yes Really Angel, and you're watching LOTV.
Hello, oh.